It's Miss McNeil. It's week three, distance learning, and we're here with the awesome KASM counselors. Give it up. We are focusing this week on social emotional well-being. We know sometimes we can get stressful, but let's hear from our counselors really quick.
You guys, I hope everyone's doing well. We miss you. We're thinking about you. We're here to help. So stay strong, guys.
Hey, it's Mr. KASM. Just want you guys to know that we're thinking about you. Hope everybody's safe and healthy.
Hey, Falcons. This is Mr. Mendez. Doing well over here. Just want you guys to know that I'm thinking of each and every one of you, and that you and your family is healthy and safe.
Hi, Falcons. We definitely miss you, and we're trying to get used to this new way of interacting as well. But just know that we are thinking of you all the time. We're sending you guys good thoughts. We hope that you're staying healthy, that your family and friends are as well. And just, yeah, be well and take care of yourselves during this time. Miss you.
So this week, our focus is social emotional well-being. And during distance learning, we know that sometimes we can get stressed, we can get anxious. So we're going to hear from our counselors today. And so first up, I'd like to ask you guys, what do you do when you're feeling overwhelmed and stressed? Give us some tips to help out our Falcons today.
Great question, Miss McNeil. Some of the things that I do when I'm overwhelmed or feeling stressed, especially during this time, because we know we all have a lot more than normal. I've actually been doing a lot of working out. I tend to clean when I get stressed. So thankfully my house is cleaner than normal right now, which is kind of nice since we're homebound. But I've been also trying to really just relax a lot more, enjoy some slower pace of life. And that seems to really help to kind of connect my mind and my spirit and just slow down and feeling more rested.
When I'm overwhelmed and stressed, believe it or not, I go in the room, blast some music, and I dance in front of the mirror.
could we see some how many of you want to see this dance? Come on, Mr. Kasten.
Yes. You want to see me dancing?
Yes.
I'll keep it right here. See the bass too. Yeah, give it to him.
Yeah.
I'm also like Mrs. Miller. When I get stressed out, I do a lot of cleaning. Luckily I have two kids and a wife and a new dog. So I'll be doing a lot of cleaning. There we go.
Well, when I'm overwhelmed and stressed, I like to take a deep breath. If I have a lot of things that I have to do, I like to make a list of the things that I have to do so that instead of them being all over the place in my mind, I can have them down and cross them out as I get them done. Another thing that's really good to do when you're stressed out, you know, like Mr. Kasten, he's more of, you know, he likes to move around. I'm more quiet. I'm more a little chiller. I like to journal. When you get sometimes you just gotta put it on paper. Journal what you're feeling, what your thoughts are. During this time, it can be a little difficult to think of, you know, to stay positive. So write through things that you're grateful for. Things that they don't have to be amazing big things. They could be things like having electricity, you know, having a bed to sleep in, having food to eat, you know, things like that, family, you know. So I like to keep myself busy by writing things down.
So when I'm feeling overwhelmed or overstressed, I have a variety of tactics that I like to use. And it kind of depends on my mood, which one I go for. But usually to start, deep breaths, I find deep breaths are very calming. And kind of depending on where I'm at, that might be 3 deep breaths, maybe it's 5, maybe it's 10. It just kind of depends. But deep breathing always kind of helps me to feel a little bit more centered and calm down and focused in kind of my mind. I recently started meditation, trying to do meditation to get some quiet space and some calmness as well. I also love to listen to music, so I'll put together playlists, again, kind of depending on the mood. Maybe I want a more upbeat playlist, or maybe I want one more that's inspirational, or dance, stuff like that. So variety of playlists I always have on hand. I also started journaling recently. And I do kind of like what Mr. Mendez was talking about. It does help just to get the feeling and the thoughts out. I don't necessarily have to do anything with them, but just getting them out so they're not bottled up inside, I have found that that's been helpful. Always talking with someone that I trust is a great outlet, you know, and right now with us all kind of being, you know, staying at home, it's helpful to reach out just to be socially connected with friends and family, but also reach out just to talk about how, you know, how you're feeling and check in, because most people are feeling pretty similar. So it helps to have that kind of reinforcement. Other things, I love to take photos. So I love to go out and take photos, but I also like to surround myself with photos, like this picture right here in the background. I'm not really at the beach. I wish I was. And then, last but not least, I mean, I love to look at animal videos, funny animal videos. Who doesn't love that, right? It's right. It's hard not to smile when you see those baby goats just jumping around, acting crazy. So, yeah, just things that kind of bring a sense of humor. I don't know. I might have to ask Mr. Kasten if he could tape some of his dance videos so I could watch those, because I know for sure that would make me smile. Just finding videos and other things that just bring humor and a little bit of lightheartedness to your day.
Awesome. So those are some of- It's so awesome to hear from our counselors today. So what we're talking about, Falcons, are emotional first aid kits. That's what we're talking about here. And so at the close today, we're going to show you some ideas how you can put together your very own emotional.
There are 6 parts to creating an emotional toolkit. Sound, create or find a playlist that brightens your mood. Sights, find images that make you smile and put them in places that you'll see every day. Touch, stress balls, stuffed animals, or a pet are excellent things for you to touch or cuddle with. Smells, find smells that make you happy, like fresh baked cookies. Humans, connect with people, hug a family member, or video call with friends or family. The last one is take action. Exercise is great for relieving stress. Dancing, cooking, organizing, or writing can all help relieve stress as well. So if you're feeling stressed or anxious, just reach in to your emotional toolkit for help.
Hopefully this has been encouraging to you, and hopefully you know that all of us here at Albiani are thinking of you, and we got you, we are here for you, and this distance learning thing, we got this. It's not going to be a problem. So thanks, counselors, for being here with us today.